this track. Alright, this little guy, my hatch over the salon, is leaking like a sieve. Probably a cup of water a minute was coming out of this puppy when it was going.
All because of these seals. Hard, not spongy. So, with this, and we'll try to see what I can do.
It's live from the leaking pirate booty boat. On this week's edition of Water Water Everywhere. All right, welcome to Pirate Booty Water Water Everywhere edition. Alright, today we want to talk about this little guy. He's going to be in your boat. Now, everybody's going to claim when you go out to West Marine and go out to where you buy all these bilge pumps from $50 to $300 and on up, right? You're going to hear these terms, gallons per hour, and you're going to hear like 1,500 gallons per hour or, you know, all this stuff, 500 gallons per hour. Now, the trouble is, you might already have this in your boat, and it might already have a pre-configured thing, and you can't get to it. Or you might want to be macho and say, I want the big 50,000 gallon an hour one, and you buy it, and you don't realize, this is the hose you have to use it with. Oh, it's only, I think, $12 a foot, so multiply that times my... I think it's like an 18-foot run, to say 20-foot, 12, you know, you're talking $250, $300 just for the hose. And you might just go out and buy something, you know, oh, I don't know, and then you get back, and you go, okay, but just off an inch. So this is why the first thing I took out of my boat was this junky thing. Two reasons. Number one, you have to leave the battery on. This has to be running all the time. You can drain your battery, right? Okay, piece of junk. All right. That little flow, which I'll show you earlier. I came in one day and a boat was full of water. It rotted out part of my wood and I was like, what the heck? Because I couldn't figure how water would go from there and get down to here. It had to be a torrential flood. No, not so much. Ugh. This cup was filled up in about 15 seconds when the storm was hitting and the water was fully flowing. I counted it, 15 seconds for that. So that means in about a minute or two, you got a gallon of water. Take a good 30, 40 minute shower. Maybe do that two times a day. Oh, trust me, I'll try to dig up some of the water that my other boat captured. It's in the hundreds of gallons, trust me, it does. I'll clip in where I finally got a automatic water bilge pump, 1,000 gallons an hour. Let's talk about that 1,000 gallons an hour, 60 minutes, right? 500 gallons every 30 minutes, 250 gallons every, you know, 15 minutes, and in 7 minutes, 125 gallons. Okay, originally I had bought a 500 gallon per hour pump. Well, that's literally under a gallon a minute. Okay. A little bit more than that, that's going to overswamp your boat. And there had to be at least 300 gallons of water in here sitting that day I came in. So, key concepts. It's not so much that how much water is coming in, unless you've totally blown a through hole, in which case, not too many bilge pumps can keep up with that. But when cases like you're restoring and you don't know because you're not out here when it rains, I was out here for a year and a half before I actually was in the boat when it was raining. I learned every one of my port lights needs to be redone. I redid up here, which I'll splice that video in, but it wasn't that. It's leaking somewhere along the bedding. Okay, that's easy. I gotta just find it, recalk it, and see how things go. So this was a great learning experience, and why I'm taking all these cushions home, and I'm not gonna leave cushions out until I can totally guarantee you this boat is leak proof. I've lost a lot of color on the fabric, it got moldy, etc., because I was never here. So if you can, simulate a rain, I don't know, with your hose or something, or actually when it rains, sit in your boat for 15 minutes. See where the leaks are.
All right, so
I got great success on my water and the water pump. I rewired that, I'm very happy. That has a dedicated switch now. And the second thing is, I have my toilet working. I actually saw everything kick in. I saw everything, but since the water that I'm flushing down is just basic water and the through hole is below the water, I can't see anything bubbling up, but I can definitely see it and feel the water moving. So that's kind of good. So with that, I feel good about my toilet, or the head as we say. That's good. I rewired the water pump, put it back on my circuit. Look at the picture up here. And you'll see how, no, you don't use those little caps and do stuff together. I have a side project. There's live AC wire underneath my sink. And there's water because he didn't cap one of the, on the two faucets, he didn't cap one. So water was cascading down within this much of AC wire. People are idiots. This guy has it just strung out like he'll use it later. You know, AC kills and burns, people. I cannot trace all those wires.
With that,
Pyro Booty feels good. I'm very happy to know where the leaks are. I have my water pump pumping, and I have dedicated my new switch, and the toilet works. The head is flushing. Double good. So water everywhere day turned out pretty damn good. And with that, the boat's a mess right now, but that's okay because I'm going to take all these cushions home, get them dried out, and get ready. I've got a bunch of new fabric coming to redo those. And I'll be painting here, I guess, tomorrow because rain. I got a rainy day. I can't paint today. All that humidity, that paint will never dry. So with that, Pyro Booty's feeling good. We're moving forward, and I'm happy. Live from Miami, Florida. Actually, the Florida Keys. Y'all have a great one. See you next week. Hey, we have water at the main sink. As you can see, it goes down there. All right, I have power the sand and flush. Hear that? I'm supposing I'm putting water in the bay.
Well, that's all, folks.